A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th Jan, on the front page you have CAA meant to give citizenship, not take it away, says PM Modi. He says those opposing amended law fueling misconception among youth. But then when CAA is meant to give citizenship, it is giving citizenship on the lines of religion and denying citizenship to those who are living in the country. Illegal migrants, those who are illegal, have committed something illegal. So illegal migrants have been staying in India till 31st December 2014. If they are from particular religious communities, they would be given citizenship. And if they are Muslims, they would not be given citizenship. So it's denying citizenship too. Then this is Jammu and Kashmir officer may have been ferrying his ultras to Delhi. So this is Jammu and Kashmir police, which said that they are investigating the role of gallantry award winning senior police officer Davinder Singh, who was ferrying two Hizbul Mujahideen militants, including wanted commander, in a civilian car on Saturday. So these officials suspect that they were planning to hit on Republic Day. Then below you have Tripura High Court says social media posting a fundamental right. So now this is a landmark order coming from Tripura High Court. It ordered the police to refrain from prosecuting a man who was earlier arrested over a social media post. So this is it. Even Chief Minister barred the police from making any further arrests in connection with the case. On page 4 you have 5 Nuh women go against all odds to study, show others way. So these are 5 women from Nuh who have gone ahead for higher studies. So they have been appointed as brand ambassadors of Nuh. So this is one of the 100 most backward districts of the country. It is in Haryana. So these 5 young Muslim women from Haryana seeking higher education have been appointed nominated as brand ambassadors of the district. No. Also, you should know that Haryana is the state with very low sex ratio and has high incidence of female feticide. On page 7 you have no progress on world's second tallest Buddha statue. So this is regarding the plan to build world's second tallest Buddha statue at Gautam Buddha in Sabarkantha district in Maharashtra. So to develop the place into an international Buddhism destination, this was the plan proposed. But now it is seen that there is no progress being made here. So this is called Dev Nimori. So this is the place in over here in Sabarkantha district, and it was proposed to build it into an international Buddhist destination. So the second tallest Buddha statue of 108 meters is in the as such in the world presently will be built here. The tallest Buddha statue is Spring Temple statue in China, which is 153 meters tall. Also, the second tallest presently is Thailand-based Sitting Buddha statue at 92 meters. Also, estimated cost of the project here was 1,200 crore rupees. But this Dev Nimori project has not big space. On page 8, you have 2 more Maradu towers brought down with precision. So, Supreme Court's order has been implemented, and these towers which have been established on CRZ, violating CRZ, Coastal Regulatory Zone Regulations. So here you can see it is very close to the water body. So Supreme Court has asked for its demolition, and all 4 apartment complexes have been razed. And below you have villagers give up stone throwing ritual at Buddhist site. So this is Buddhist site in Andhra Pradesh called Bojjana Konda. So it's a Buddhist monastery dating back to 3rd century BC in Vishakhapatnam district in Andhra Pradesh. So intact campaign and efforts by officials of Bojjana Konda has convinced residents to shun the practice of stone throwing. So this stone throwing ritual actually affects the site. So now this ancient ritual is being given up. So there is a belly shaped object at the site which is believed to be a part of a demon, and stone throwing is practiced there. On page 9 you have India's under 5 girls face high mortality. So it says unlike the global trends, in India they have high probability of dying than boys. generally girls survive better than boys, but in India it is the other way around. According to UN report, it says among bigger states in India, gender gap in the under 5 mortality rate was most pronounced in Jharkhand. Then Madhya Pradesh has highest overall under 5 mortality, while Kerala has the least. So this is the data provided about it. Under 5 mortality rate among boys, girls and the gap. And actually mortality rate is higher for, naturally higher for boys than girls. Then you have Kaziranga is one of the highest number of wetlands of birds. So this is the second survey conducted here, which recorded 19,225 birds belonging to 80 families. So it is the second wetland bird count conducted, and Kaziranga has around 96 species of wetland birds. It is one of the highest for wildlife reserves in India. 96 different species. So total birds are 19,225. 96 species and under 80 families. So first census was in 2018 and now the next one has been conducted. And here you have, private property is a fundamental right, says Supreme Court. So grabbing private land and claiming it as its own makes the state an encroacher is what the Supreme Court has ruled here. So we know that right to property was earlier a fundamental right, and in 1978 through the 44th constitutional amendment, right to property was removed from the section on fundamental rights and inserted elsewhere in the constitution. It is still a right, a constitutional right under article 308. And the state should follow due process and authority of law to deprive a person of his or her private property. So that is still a right, a constitutional right. So, but the Supreme Court here has ruled it is a fundamental right, private property, because it says in a welfare state, right to property is a human right. So it can be derived under Article 21 of the Constitution too. So this is the ruling. It says state cannot take possession of property without following due procedure and authority of law. So state cannot trespass into private property of a citizen and then claim ownership of the land in the name of adverse possession. So grabbing private land and then claiming it as its own makes the state an encroacher is what the Supreme Court ruled. On the editorial page, the first editorial is man-made disaster. So this is regarding Iran's admission that the civilian aircraft which was brought down was an error through it. So it says Iran should have had safety steps for civilian aircraft while preparing for enemy retaliation. So this was a tragic disaster which took place because of escalated tensions between USA and Iran. A civilian aircraft coming in was targeted, mistakenly targeted by Iran. And this is matter of interpretation. So it says overall crime rate in India in 2018 has increased marginally since 2016. But this Crime of India report for 2017 and National Crime Record Bureau's 2018 report, what is to be understood through them and how they need to be interpreted is important. So you can see it is said that these crime record statistics are good, but some states are better than others. But what is important is that how they are interpreted and how action is taken to rectify or improve these numbers. So also crime rate depends on reporting too. So better reporting will increase the rates too. The warp and weft of religious liberty. So it says in expounding the scope and extent of freedom of religion, the Supreme Court faces the difficult question of balance. That how would the Supreme Court balance on this, because in December 2014 the Supreme Court had placed a temporary ban on Madhesnana, which is a 500 year old ritual performed at Kukke Subramaniam temple in Karnataka. So this practice involves persons, in particular those from SC and ST, rolling over plantain leaves left behind with food half eaten by the Brahmins. So the belief was that doing so would cleanse their skin of impurities. So in 2014, Supreme Court had placed a temporary ban here. Even in 2012, at the behest of a group of progressive minded petitioners, including the seer of the Nidumamidi Math, a division bench of Karnataka High Court had put a halt on the ritual. But it was allowed to continue in a modified form. form, but now devotees voluntarily choose to roll over leaves containing prasad, and that is of the prasad, that is offering to the deity, so long as food was not tasted or partially eaten by members of any community. This is like a religious ritual, and a Supreme Court ruling on that. So Supreme Court faced difficulty of question of balance, because within the Constitution of India there are two impulses that may at times come into conflict with one another. The first impulse recognizes that India is a pluralist and diverse nation, where the groups and communities, whether religious or cultural, have always played an important role in society. And second impulse is that Constitution recognizes both the freedom of religion as an individual right, as well as right of religious denominations to manage their own affairs in matters of religion. So now here it is recognizing community to be source of solidarity at the best of times. So the how can now this be there? So it can also have result in oppression and exclusion within the religious community, how they manage their affairs. So how the Supreme Court would rule on these matters, how to balance religious matters, is a question put forth. So finding a middle ground, how to strike a balance, respecting the autonomy of cultural and religious communities, and also ensuring that individual rights are not entirely sacrificed at the altar of the community. Anti-exclusion principle is what the Supreme Court rules on. So there's a 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court which is going to look into whether the Supreme Court or whether the courts can get involved in questions of religious faith. So ruling would come on this. There's an article talking about that. And this is a case which has been referred to a higher bench in the context of Sabarimala temple entry. So in an appeal in that case, Supreme Court said that it will refer this question on religion first to a larger bench, that to what extent Supreme Court can intervene and adjudicate on religious matters, and then it would hear the appeal on Sabarimala case. Until that time, the Sabarimala ruling of the Supreme Court, the landmark ruling allowing women temple entry irrespective of age, has not been stayed, but then its implementation has been stayed by the Kerala government as such. Then this is in martyrdom moments for Iran, America's own goal. So you can see US's hand in Qasem Soleimani's assassination, it is said, may have only aided Iran by stirring up nationalist and religious passions. So that's how it has helped Iran. On op-ed page, you have favoring public order over justice. So the Supreme Court's order on internet shutdown in Jammu and Kashmir was a statist expression of law. So this is an article talking about the Supreme Court ruling, where it said that undue restrictions cannot be placed, but it did not call for the government to rectify what it has already done or to take action to ensure that, you know, rights are fully restored. So that was missing in the ruling. This is there. So favoring public order over justice. Then below you have lessons from Marudu. So this is regarding the demolitions of high rises in Marudu, which took place because they violated CRZ norms, coastal regulatory zone norms. So it says this demolition will persuade builders against committing future violations. So that is important lesson learned through this entire case. Then on international page you have Iran agrees de-escalation is the only way to solve the crisis. So protesters are angry over handling of plane crisis and want leaders to quit, while Trump warns that Iran cannot kill demonstrators. So this is them. And below you have rival Libya groups agree to ceasefire. So both sides in Libya's conflict have agreed to a ceasefire to end 9 months of fighting following weeks of international diplomacy and calls for a truce by power brokers Russia and Turkey. So Libya, which is a North African country, an oil-rich country, has been wrecked by bloody turmoil since NATO-backed uprising killed long-time dictator Muammar Gaddafi in 2011. So multiple foreign powers are now involved and there are multiple factions fighting. Finally, the truce, a ceasefire, has been brought among them. And on Sundays, on business page, you have this money-wise coverage, which is for individual economic decisions. So this you can skip. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.